In the last video, we introduced all the controls you have to take care of while driving this car. It's time to start learning about how to use them properly in every situation. This chapter will tell you all you need to know about what to do in qualifying sessions. This car is quite tricky to qualify properly, because you cannot do two consecutive good laps. A car with enough energy to complete a full lap in hotlap mode is always going to be much faster. It doesn't matter how much you nail every corner next time around, the lack of power will not allow you to be competitive. But it's not only about power, the tires are also a big factor. The compounds we have for this car are quite similar to the real Pirelli tires in some details. It is true they don't lose the initial grip as fast as the real ones, these usually have one great lap and then lose a chunk of performance. The tires in the game do not do that, but the soft compounds will be overheated by the end of one full attack lap. They will need a cooldown lap after that. Let's see how to handle the outlaps then. We'll talk about both the hybrid controls and the tires. The first thing you want to do after exiting the pits is to set delivery mode to charge. The battery is already full, but you don't want the car to start deploying energy. Next, you want the recovery settings for the MGUK at 100%. The idea is not to recover energy, you will probably still have like 95% left by now, and that will be 100% after just one braking zone. The idea is being one click away from zero recovery, that is what you will need to select starting the lap that counts. Make sure MGUH is set to motor. You don't need to charge the battery, so you can go straight to the setting you want for the hot lap. It's worth you get out of the way. Always keep your tire temperatures in mind. You don't want to stress the tires in this lap. With or without blankets, the softest compounds will always be ready by the start of the hot lap. You can set your desired brake balance and engine brake settings for the hot lap in advance too. Your work is pretty much over until the last corner or two. Just keep going around being gentle on the tires and keep an eye on cars catching you. Get out of the way of possible traffic coming from behind in a fast lap. As we enter sector 3, you can see that even coasting all the way, my tires are still ready for the big push. Keep them on the cool side if you can. Now, we start setting the hybrid side of the car for the hot lap. We make sure MGUH is in motor mode. Then we disable MGUK recovery. And finally, we set the hotlap map as we approach the last corner. We are good to go for an optimum qualifying lap now. All that is left to do is to drive it as well as you can. There isn't much work outside the driving itself during the hotlap, but let's still dedicate some time to it. This is by no means a good lap. It is pretty much the first driving of that day, and I didn't bother taking fuel off, but it does illustrate well the few points I want to make about hot laps. The first is, do not mess with the hybrid settings. You will never need to as long as your battery is full starting the lap. This is Spa, the longest track of the Formula 1 calendar. I will drive with no recovery at all, and I will still manage to complete the lap without running out of power. You can work with the brake bias of your car as you approach different corners, but leave the delivery and recovery options alone. The other point is about the tires. Spa is a demanding track, full of fast corners. I am not even using the super soft, I am using default pressures too, and still, you'll see severe overheating by the end of the lap. Keep an eye on the tire temperatures from now on, and how they can destroy the last part of your lap. Yeah. You can see I still have plenty of energy left. Now we will switch to the Red Bull Ring to highlight how different compounds will suit different tracks, and how you can't always jump straight to the softest compound. This track is not only much shorter, but also less demanding on tires. Now I am using the Super Soft, and it's going to last the whole lap perfectly fine. Keep an eye on the temperatures again. The tire hangs so well that if you're careful you could consider to use it as a race tire for a shorter stint. Now we'll talk about a very important and usually overlooked skill. Since you cannot do two qualifying laps in a row, it is extremely important to recognize soon when a lap is not going anywhere. It is also critical to react quickly and start messing with the hybrid controls to make sure you are ready to try again next lap. Recovering energy while you cool down the tires is very hard. These are conflicting targets, and getting to the line with a full battery and cool tires is not easy at all. You cannot afford to drive very slowly because you won't recover enough energy. You cannot push because you are going to heat up the tires too much. So what are you supposed to do? Let's see a couple of aborted attempts to find out. In this first one, we will focus on the hybrid controls. It's all going to be real quick, so I'll explain what to do beforehand. As soon as you decide to abort, switch from Hotlap to Charge mode, then crank up Kinetic Energy Recovery to full. These are the top priorities. Then switch MGUH to Battery mode when you can. Let's see how to do it. Now we got that out of the way, let's talk about how to drive the rest of the lap to get the car ready. Let's see another aborted hot lap and I'll explain what to do. Right after you put all the switches in the right positions, you have to keep enough speed up to arrive fast to the heavy braking zones. Accelerate smoothly, avoid any wheel spin, gather speed, and attack the braking areas hard, but without locking up. Take it very easy, mid-corner and on-corner exit. If the next corner doesn't have a decent braking zone, don't build speed up. Coast and protect the tires. As soon as the next heavy braking zone is on sight, gather speed and attack it. Now, another fast corner ahead, so we just coast into it. Once the battery is full, you don't need to attack the braking zones anymore. All the focus goes to protecting the tires. Then, as you approach to the last corner, put the switches back in the right position for the hot lap and simply try again. It is fairly easy to get the car ready for the next lap if you abort early on, but if you mess up a good lap towards the end, it is much harder. You don't have time to fully reload the battery or to cool the tires down. Even if you are fast on the switches and drive as we saw before, it's impossible to get ready again so fast. So, what are your options now? First is to do another hot lap anyway, this time with recovery on. You'll be a bit slower, but if time is running out and you haven't completed a good lap yet, it is worth a try. Second is to do another full cooldown lap where you can properly reload the battery and give tires a break. This takes time and you need to have the fuel on board to pull it, but the lap is likely to end up being faster. given the way Assetto Corsa works right now, you can always respawn at the pits immediately. But that should be fixed eventually, so it's worth to learn how to deal with this situation. And that was all for this video. Next time, we will talk about how to handle all this stuff on race day. Thanks for watching.